Welcome to today's online class, children. Today we are going to solve some simple numericals on electromagnetic induction, which are very important also. Okay. Now the first question is, say a coil having 500 square loops, each of side 10 centimeter, is placed normal to the magnetic field, which increases at the rate of 1 Tesla per second. 1 Tesla per second. What is the EMF induced in the loop? Okay, a coil having, now what are all the things given here? A coil having number of turns is given, therefore N, that is equal to 500. Fine. And each of square loops, each of side 10 centimeter. Therefore, it is a square loop. Therefore, which means that area can be found out. A square loop. Okay. Each of, what is that? Side 10 centimeter. Therefore, that is equal to A. Therefore, what is A? A, it is equal to square. Therefore, 10 into 10 centimeter squared. Fine. And I want in meters squared. Therefore, it is 10 squared. Consider, convert it to meters squared. Therefore, 10 power minus 4. Meter squared. Okay, therefore, H will be equal to 10 power minus 2 meters squared. Okay, then, next one. What is given? The magnetic field which increases at the rate of 1 Tesla per second. Tesla per second. Therefore, what is given here increases at the rate of, magnetic field is increasing. Therefore, it is dB by dt is given, correct? That is equal to 1 Tesla per second. Fine. So everything is there. You are asked to find out the EMF. Therefore, how EMF E, that is equal to induced EMF. Therefore, EMF is equal to solution. We will see EMF, that is nothing but number of turns is there, N into d phi by dt. Okay, therefore, that is nothing but, okay, N. A, phi is equal to AB na? Phi is equal to B dot A. Okay, therefore, here, for what is N? That N into d phi by dt. Therefore, it is d by dt of BA. But area is not changing. What is changing here is only magnetic field. Therefore, you can say it is number of turns. You can even say that phi, that is equal to number of turns, the N, that is equal to NBA also. N into d phi by dt, and phi is equal to N, what is it, NBA, whatever is that. Okay, therefore it is N, what is called A, into dB by dt, dB by dt, and that is nothing but N is 500, and A is 10 power minus 2, and what is dB by dt is 1. Okay, therefore, what is your E? Therefore, E is equal to 5 volt. E is equal to 5 volt. Okay, direction you know very well, it is opposing. Therefore, minus d phi by dt na, is equal to, therefore, it is not, E is equal to 5 volt. It is magnitude. Okay, right. Now, next one. See, very simple. Then a horizontal conducting rod, okay, 10 centimeter long, extending from east to west, is falling with a speed of 5 meter per second at right angles to the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. Okay, my X magnetic field is 0.3 into 10 to the power minus 4 Weber per meter square. Find the instantaneous value of the EMF in the coil. So now, what are all the first, what are all the things given after that explain? See, L, what a horizontal conducting rod of length is 10, it is 10 meter, it is not centimeter, it is 10 meter. Okay, given is 10 meter long, extending from east to west, is falling with a speed of 5 meter per second, right? Therefore, what are all the things given here is L, that is equal to 10 meter, okay, and it is move falling with a velocity is given b, that is equal to 5 meter per second. Fine. Then next one, what is horizontal component of Earth's field at that place? And h, that is equal to 0.3 × 10⁻⁴ Weber per meter square. Weber per meter squared by, you know that phi, that is equal to BA. B dot A cos theta. BA cos theta. Therefore, B, that is equal to phi by A na. Okay. Therefore, phi BA cos theta, if theta is equal to 0. Okay. Therefore, 1. Cos theta is equal to 1. B, that is equal to phi by Weber per meter square. Therefore, B is Tesla or it is Weber per meter square. Therefore, now next one, what is asked? Therefore, that E is equal to what? E is equal to what? And now you understand that the rod is falling 90 degrees. Therefore, you see here, if this is your horizontal component of the field, BH, okay? And the rod is, how rod is falling actually, you know? Actually, rod is falling like this. It is, rod is like this, perpendicular to the plane of the board, and okay, like that, inward or outward, whatever is that, the rod is kept like this. Therefore, are you following rod, how it is kept perpendicular to the plane of the board, like that. Therefore, it is therefore, which means it is perpendicular to the horizontal component of Earth's field also, no? So, and it is falling like that, the rod is like this, and it is falling here, 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 like that is falling. Are you following? So you have to understand like this. Okay. Therefore, perpendicular to the plane, and therefore, what is it? It is falling like this. Falling. You cannot say it is not magnetic. Magnetic field is horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. I just want to tell, just show it to you how the rod is falling. Rod is, how is it falling? It is oriented such that, what is that? Perpendicular to the plane of the board. Like that is falling from up to. That is top to bottom like that. Okay. Therefore, now theta, therefore the definite is equal to 90 degrees. Okay. Therefore, you are asked for E. Therefore, what is E? E, that is equal to, I think theta is equal to 90 degrees. Therefore, you can say so E is equal to BLV na? BLV sine theta. BLV sine 90 degrees. Therefore, E, that is equal to, what is that? BLV. Okay, let me give you easy. Okay, I don't know what. He, that is equal to BLV. Okay, and B is nothing but BH. You can say it is horizontal component of Earth's field. Usually we are denoting it by BH na. BH or whatever is that. I think we did with our theory with as BH. We have use this, okay? BH and BV. Horizontal component is BH and vertical component is BV. Whatever is that, okay? Therefore, it is BHLV. Okay, therefore, now what is that? BH is equal to 0.3 × 10⁻⁴, and L is 10, okay? And V is nothing but 5 meter per second, okay? Therefore, you will be getting E as 1.5 × 10⁻³ volt. E is equal to 1.5 × 10⁻³ volt. That's it. Very simple. Okay. Right. We'll go to the next. Next is a plot of magnetic flux phi versus current I is shown for two inductors A and B. Which of the two has larger value of inductance? What inductance? Self-inductance. Which is having, see, in the inductance means what is it here? Because it is having two different inductors are there, A and B, of which is having more larger value of inductance. Okay, therefore, very simple, I think you know, for self-inductance is given by phi, that is equal to L into I. A or B, which is having more self-inductance. Inductance means self-inductance here, okay? Therefore, L, that is equal to phi by I. Correct? Phi by I. Therefore, you are given the plot between phi and I. Therefore, how to find out the slope gives you phi by I, na? the slope of this what is that a and b, if you find out the slope, how to find out the simple method, I think, what is that here, just you draw one I, constant I you take, okay, and corresponding to a here this is phi a, and corresponding to b the flux here is phi b. Okay, therefore you can say L A, inductance for A, of the inductance, self inductance of the inductor A. Inductor means what is the solenoid? Okay, whatever. Therefore L A, that is equal to phi A by I, because both are having same current. That's why I have taken same current. Okay, for same current, what is the flux? Flux linked with A and B, that is phi A and phi B respectively. Therefore, what is the self inductance of A? LA. What is the self inductance for B? LB. LB, that is equal to what is that? Phi B by I. Okay, therefore, I think very well. Here you can make out that phi A is more than phi. Phi A is more than phi B. Okay, and therefore, LA is more than LB because both are having for the same current. I is the same now. Therefore, here, if you find which has more slope, on seeing that itself, you can find out because you have done so many problems of this type. Anyhow, therefore, it is A is having more slope. Slope gives you directly what is the self inductance. Therefore, which is having more larger value of inductance here? A, the inductor A. Right. Next. Next one is current in the wire XY is decreasing steadily, right? Predict the direction of induced current in the metal rings 1 and 2, both. Okay, very good. Current in the wire XY is decreasing steadily. In which direction current? Current is from right to left. Okay. And it is decreasing steadily. It is continuously, it is decreasing. Current is decreasing. Therefore, when the current is decreasing, therefore, now you just to find out what is the, you know that current carrying conductor is having a magnetic field. Therefore, magnetic field, how the magnet by using right hand thumb rule, how to draw the magnetic field lines. Magnetic field lines are such that, okay, magnetic field lines are such that I am going to draw, see here, magnetic field lines will be, if you draw, see, thumb is towards left. Curvature of the finger shows the magnetic field line. Therefore, magnetic field line will be, it will be like this. How? Here, see, it is going on blue 1 in the coil 1, circular coil 1. It, the lines will be moving inward. Okay, like that you will be having concentric circles now. Here, like that. Okay, so how it will be? It is going such that it is going like the inward and it comes out. Therefore, it is not, it is at in the coil 1, the field is going inward, and in coil 2, the field lines are going outward. Therefore, here I am going to show it. Here it is outward. Flux lines are here outward. But in one, it is inward. Or first, that you have to first fix it. Okay, therefore, now is it clear? There is no need. And now I think you have understood, no? There is no need for these circles and all, so that it may. Okay, I think this field line, circles means what is that? It's a field line. So I think now you can understand here. Okay, let me rub these things. So that now I am going to show only field lines, that is cross and dot. Now you very well, you can understand what is what, you know the meaning of it. Okay, therefore, now you see here, this is the line, and here is the field line, the flux lines in one is inward, perpendicular to the plane of the board and inward. Therefore, I am going to show here, this is inward field lines. Okay, and what about the field lines here? Two, it is going perpendicular and outward. Therefore, outward. Let me show this one by dots. Okay. Now you tell me. Now, once you know this one is very important here. यार ऊपर तो क्या, इट इज गोइंग इनवर्ड एंड इन टू इट इज कमिंग आउटवर्ड. ओके वेरी गुड. नाउ इट इज इजी. डिक्रीजिंग करंट. डिक्रीजिंग करंट मीन्स व्हाट इज दैट? द फ्लक्स लाइन्स हियर ओके लिंक्ड विथ वननेस ऑल्सो एज करंट इज डिक्रीजिंग द फ्लक्स लाइन्स हियर इट इज डिक्रीजिंग लिंक्ड विथ वन एंड टू दे आर डिक्रीजिंग. Here perpendicular one in one perpendicular inward that flux lines are decreasing and perpendicular to and outward in coil 2 okay that is also decreasing. Why? Because the current is decreasing. Because of the decreasing current there will be a induced current in 1 and 2 in the coil 1 and 2. 1 is just above xy and 2 is just below xy. Are you following? That itself gives you actually that is why it gives the difference. The field lines in one it is perpendicular and inward, and two it is perpendicular and outward. And those flux lines are also not constant, but it is decreasing. Okay, with respect to one, we'll see the inward flux lines are in decreasing. Inward flux lines are decreasing, and because of that, there will be an induced current. And this induced current does not want the inward field lines to decrease. Does not want the inward field lines to decrease. Are you following? Therefore, what it will induce a current in the coil such that it will also produce the inward field lines. It will also produce the inward so that what? If at all, what is that? Due to xy, the current in xy, if it decreases, inward field lines, because of the decrease, there will be an induced current in 1. And the induced current is such that it does not allow the field lines to, inward field lines to decrease. How? Therefore, just by inducing a clockwise current. Once the current is clockwise, you know that once again use right hand thumb rule. Okay, therefore curvature is your now current, therefore your thumb shows the field lines na, therefore inward or na, therefore it will add up some inward field lines so that by adding some extra inward field lines, it tries to, what is that? Decrease the field, inward field lines linked with one. Hope you are following. Because of decreasing current, there is a decrease in the inward field lines. Okay, perpendicular and inward field lines in one. Due to that, there will be an induced current. And the induced current is such that it opposes the decrease in the inward field lines. How? So that, therefore, how the current will be in the clockwise direction. Once the current is in the clockwise direction, automatically because of that current, there will be, what is that, field lines, magnetic field lines, which is inward field lines will be there. Are you following? Just by using right hand thumb rule. Now come to do. Okay, in two the field lines say due to xy, what is it, due to the current in xy, the field lines are actually inward, what is that, perpendicular plane of the coil 2 and outward. Okay, so once the current is decreasing here, therefore what will happen, the magnetic outward field lines, magnetic field lines linked with the 2 is also decreasing. Okay, because of the decrease in the magnetic field lines, magnetic flux, magnetic inward field lines means what is a magnetic flux linked with the coil 2. Okay, therefore there will be an induced EMF. Therefore, the direction of the induced EMF is such that, okay, it opposes the decrease in the current. It opposes the decrease in the outward, it is outward field lines. In 2, what is that? It outward field lines, sorry. Here one only inward field lines, two it is field lines which are perpendicular to the plane of the coil and outward, or plane of the board here and outward. That should be, that there is a decrease in the outward field lines. flux lines, which is moving outward. Okay, so how to oppose it? It doesn't want the decrease. How to oppose it? Just by inducing a current. How? In the anti-clockwise direction. Inducing a current in the anti-clockwise direction. Once a current is in the anti-clockwise direction, use once again right hand thumb rule. Okay, anti-clockwise direction means what is that? The thumb shows the field lines. No, that will be outward field lines. No. Okay, so your induced current here is such that, okay, it gives rise to some extra flux, that is field lines, magnetic field lines, which is going outward, which is perpendicular to the plane of the coil and outward. Okay, thereby opposing the decrease in the magnetic flux. Are you following? So this is very, very important. Very, very important. What happens? The same thing. If it is increasing current is flowing, it just opposes it. Increasing means what is that? If the current is increasing, therefore what will happen? The flux lines in one is increasing. Flux lines in one is increasing. Where in one is increasing, which flux lines? Inward flux lines are increasing. It doesn't want that increase in the inward flux lines. Okay? Are you following? Magnetic field lines? It doesn't want. Okay, therefore, what will be the direction of the current here? It will be in the anticlockwise direction in that case. Okay, just opposite. Okay, if there is increase means it opposes the increase in magnetic flux. If there is decrease means it opposes the decrease in the magnetic. Accordingly, what is it? The current will be there, whether it is a clockwise current or anticlockwise current, depending upon that. Is it clear? Okay, very simple. Right, next one. The south pole of a magnet is brought near a conducting loop, which is the what is the direction of induced current as seen by the person on the other side of the loop. On the other side of the loop. Okay, south pole of the magnet is brought near the conducting loop. Okay, this is the conducting loop. Therefore, south pole is brought. Okay, what is the direction of the induced current as seen by the person on the other side? Here, I is this side. Okay, for this, for him, what is the direction of the current in the loop? Okay, you know very well there will be some induced current. Why? Because now south pole is brought. Therefore, the magnetic flux linked with the coil will increase. Okay, such that. The face towards south will be south. South pole of the magnet will be south. And this side here, with respect to this, it will be north. Correct? So, if the coil is like this, see, for example, if the coil is like this, this is the coil. Correct? This is the coil. And for this side, this face of the coil will be south. Why? Because south pole is coming towards it. But this face of the coil will be north. Correct? Okay. Therefore, now our person, the I is here. I is here means this face has to be for him. It is north. North means what should be the direction of the current here for him. See, what is the direction of the induced for him? It has to be anticlockwise now. For him, it has to be anticlockwise. Are you following? If this one person is here, for example, one more person is here. For him, the current will be clockwise. Okay, that is why it is very clearly given. As seen by the person on the other side of the loop, that matters. Where is the observer? The observer is to the right of the loop, means for him, it appears anticlockwise. If the observer is to the left of the loop, means he will be seeing this as south pole, therefore clockwise. Very, very important. With respect to the observer, what is the direction of the current will change. Hope you are following, children. Right? Then next one. A coil BS connected to a low voltage bulb L low voltage bulb, this is L, okay, L, and placed parallel to the other coil A, okay, as shown. Okay, that both are kept parallel like this. Okay, so now you are asked to find out what is that? Explain the following observations. Actually, explain the following observations. Very simple. Number one, bulb lights. Number one is bulb lights. What is the reason for the bulb? See, why? How it lights? Actually, see here, very important here is two are kept. A and B, one above the other. Okay, A and B is above A. Okay, now what happened here? Very important. A, that is AC. It is connected to AC, correct? Therefore, see A and B are connected to, a coil B. This is B. A coil B is connected to a low voltage bulb and placed parallel to the coil A. Okay, right. Therefore, now A is connected to AC. A is connected to AC. Once there is AC, means what is the alternating current? Alternating current is flowing, means definitely flux linked with A will change. Flux linked with A is changing, means A and B are very close. Okay, therefore, flux linked with B will also change. Flux linked with B is changing, means because of mutual induction. Because of mutual induction, because they are very close. Okay. Therefore, because of mutual induction, flux change linked with B will also change. Therefore, there will be an induced, EMF, and hence that's induced current. The induced current will be flowing through the, coil B. And this coil B is connected to the bulb. Therefore, there will be induced EMF is there. Therefore, it will be induced current in the circuit. Hence, the bulb L glows. Because of, mutual induction. Because of mutual induction, whenever there is a change in the magnetic flux linked with the coil and EMF is induced in the neighboring coil, correct? Therefore, here A, there is a change in the magnetic flux. Therefore, B, magnetic flux linked with B will also change. Okay, because both are very close. Therefore, there will be EMF induced and hence induced current. And because of the induced current that is flowing through this coil number, it is 1 and two, coil number 2, circuit number 2, coil is A and B, circuit number 2, therefore that will be, bulb will be glowing here, okay. Then next one is bulb gets dimmer if the coil B is moved upward, okay, very simple. Now I am moving the coil B upward. Once I am moving the coil upward, okay, see, A is connected to AC. Therefore, there will be continuously, there will be some magnetic flux linked with A. Change in the magnetic flux linked with A. There will be some change in the magnetic flux linked with B also, of course. Okay, but B is moved, away from A. B is moved away from A means... What do you understand by this? See here, the mutual induction, effective mutual induction, actually, that will decrease. Why? Because coefficient of mutual induction M no, between the coil, it will decrease. You know very well, it depends upon the distance between the two coils. No? More the distance, less will be the... mutual inductance linked with between the coils A and B. Therefore, the effect of mutual induction will decrease as B is moved upward. Therefore, hence the mutual inductance of the pair of coil definitely it will decrease. Mutual inductance of the coil is decreasing means you know very well EMF that is equal to M into di by dt. Okay, therefore M is decreasing here. Why? Because the distance of separation is decreased. The effect of mutual induction is decreased when the coil B is moved upward. Why? Because M is decreasing. Okay, I'm telling you once again, M depends on so many things, orientation of the coil and distance between the coils, everything we have seen. No? Therefore, distance between the coil is increased. Therefore, M definitely automatically mutual induction of this pair of coils A and B will decrease. Therefore, M is decreasing means EMF E will also decrease. Okay, when the EMF is decreased, automatically the current in the circuit too definitely it will decrease. Okay, EMF linked with what? EMF linked with B, EB. Are you following? Therefore, EB, the EMF linked, induced EMF. EMF got linked. EMF across the coil B is decreased. Induced EMF will be decreased. Why? M is decreasing. Okay, so EMF is decreased means the current through two will also decrease. Current is decreasing means definitely what will happen? The bulb grows dimmer. Bulb grows dimmer. Is it clear? First one, bulb glows. Bulb glows why? Because of mutual induction. Whenever the flux linked with the A is changing, then what is that? The EMF will be induced in the neighboring coil. Why? Because there will be change in the magnetic flux linked with B also, hence that will be induced EMF, hence induced current. Therefore, in the coil 2, the current flows, hence L, the bulb glows. As next one, as B is taken upward, then effect of mutual induction is decreased. Effect of mutual induction is decreased. Why? Because M, the mutual coefficient of mutual induction between A and B will decrease. Okay, therefore the induced EMF in the coil B will decrease. Hence, the current in the in the circuit 2 definitely automatically will decrease. Hence, the bulb becomes what is it? Goes dim. Okay. Next, a magnetic flux through a coil is varying according to the relation phi is equal to 5t cube 4t squared plus 2t minus 5 Weber. Calculate the induced current through the coil at t is equal to 2 seconds. And if the resistance of the coil is 5 ohm, coil is 5 ohm. Right. Therefore, what are all the things given? You tell me what is given. Phi is given. Therefore, what is phi? Phi that is equal to 5t cube plus 4t. So, the equation is given. How phi is changing with respect to time? How it changes? It is given in equation 2t minus 5 Weber. Okay, now calculate the induced EMF. Okay, at what is the time? Time that is at EMF that is equal to what? Okay, and what is the time given? Time given here is at 2 seconds. Induced current at T is equal to 2 seconds. And what is the coil? Resistance of the coil. Resistance of the coil is also given at 5 ohm. So you are asked for induced current. Okay. Right. First you have to find out induced EMF. And then after that you have to find out what is induced current. Finally you have to find out induced current. Very good. Therefore how to find it out? So you know you are given 5. Therefore, E that is equal, you know, variable E that is equal to d phi by dt minus d phi by dt, and therefore it is magnitude is d phi by dt. Okay. Therefore, what is that? It is d by dt of, okay, phi is phi t cube plus 4t squared plus 2t minus 5. Okay, differentiate. That's it. Therefore, differentiate it. Once you differentiate, it is 15t squared, correct? Plus 8t plus 2 minus 5 is constant. Zero. Okay. Therefore, 15t squared plus 8t plus 2. Okay. Therefore, but you have to find out this is. This gives you, what is that? How EMF changes with respect to time. But you want EMF at t is equal to 2 seconds. Okay, therefore it is asked, t is equal, therefore Therefore, it is an equation. How EMF changes with time. Therefore, when t that is equal to 2 seconds, t is equal to 2 seconds, therefore, what is E? E that is equal to, okay, 15 into 2 squared plus 8 into t. 8 into t plus 2. Okay, therefore, what is that? 15 into 4 plus 8 into t. T is 2. 8 into t now. 8 into 2. Right. Therefore, if you find out, the value will be 78 volt. Okay. Therefore, 15 into 4, 8 into 2 plus 2. Right. Therefore, you know what is the EMF, you know. But you are asked for current. Therefore, induced current. It is induced EMF. Therefore, induced current, I that is equal to induced EMF divided by R. That is nothing but 78 divided by 5. Okay, 78 by 5. Therefore, it is, that is equal to 15.6 amps. 15.6 amps. Are you following? So, this is the induced current. Okay, right. Next one. Next one, let's see, a solenoid of radius 3 cm and length 1 meter has 600 turns per meter. What is its self-inductance? Okay. Will the value of self-inductance change if it is wound on the iron piece? Okay, right, very good. Now, a solenoid of radius 3 cm. Okay, radius diya hai. What is R? R is equal to 3 cm. Therefore, convert 3 into 10 power minus 2 meter. And what is the length given as L is equal to 1 meter, right? And what is the total number of turns is given? Total number of turns that is equal to 600. Fine. What is the self-inductance? Therefore, what is L is equal to what? Self-inductance, it is denoted by capital L, right? L is equal to what? Therefore, what is the formula for that? Self-inductance of a solenoid. Okay, for L, that is equal to mu naught N squared A by cap. What is the length of the solenoid? L. Okay, what is A here? A that is equal to how to pi r squared. A is the area of the coil, na? Pi r squared. Therefore, if you substitute 3.14 into, what is r? 3 into 10 power minus 2 the whole squared. Okay, therefore, you will be getting, okay, let it be pi only, y unnecessarily too. Okay. Therefore, let it be, now you have to, okay, pi r squared. Therefore, substitute now. That is nothing but 9 pi r. Okay, 9 pi into 10 power, whatever is it, 10 power minus 4. 10 power minus 4 meters squared. Okay. Therefore, substituting, you will be getting mu naught. What is mu naught? Mu naught is 4 pi into 10 power minus 7. So, everything is known. R, L, everything. R, from R, you have found out, what is that, area. Total number of turns is known, L is known. Therefore, substitute into, okay, 600, number of turns is 600 the whole square, into 9 pi, 9 into 3.14, into 10 power minus 4, okay, in that is, okay, divided by L is 1. Okay, therefore, the value once calculate and find out, whether check the answer, okay, it is 1.28. into 10 power minus 3. What is the unit for its Henry? Self-index. 1.28 into 10 power minus 3 Henry. Okay. Right. Now, next part you see. Will the value of self-inductance change if it is wound on an iron piece? Okay. I think I told you while we are discussing that derivation. If it is wound on some other material, some other medium. Now it is air medium. Okay. And therefore, L becomes now in that case, second part I'm telling. L becomes mu n squared a by L. Okay, and that is nothing but mu naught mu r n squared a by L. Okay, mu is a mu is the permeability of the medium. What is the medium here? Soft iron, iron piece. Okay, therefore, definitely, therefore, it will be mu naught mu r n squared a by L. Therefore, definitely, your it is nothing but L that is equal to relative permeability into now L dash. Let it be L. It is L na L dash. So L dash karo L dash. That is equal to mu on to mu naught n squared a by L is nothing but L na. Okay, therefore L dash is with the medium core soft triangle. Therefore L dash equal to mu r into L. What is mu r? Mu r is nothing but relative permeability of the medium, that is iron. Okay, therefore definitely it will increase. Okay, this will the value of self inductance definitely it will increase when it is wound on an iron core. Okay, that's it. Now next, if a current of 3 ampere flowing in a coil is reduced to 0 in 0.001 second, then the induced EMF in secondary coil is neighboring coil, okay, coil is 15,000 volt. What is the mutual inductance between the two coils? Okay, therefore, what are all the things given? First you tell me. So that here, what is that di by dt given? Why? Because a current of 3 amps flowing in a coil is reduced to 0 in 0.001 second. Okay. Therefore, what is di? Change in current. Current is only reduced or deduced. Okay. Zero. Reduced to 0. Therefore, final current minus initial current, di. Okay, therefore this is di. And what is dt? Dt here is nothing but 0.001 second. Okay, therefore what is di by dt? Di by dt is equal to minus 3, and I say di is equal to minus 3 divided by 0.001 seconds. Okay, therefore that will be equal to 3000 ho jayega na, 3000 minus with the minus sign, minus 3000 ampere per second. The negative sign shows that the current is reduced, di, correct? Therefore, minus 3000 ampere per second will be di by dt. Okay, and what else is given? Induced EMF. It induces EMF in the secondary coil. Therefore, it is mutual induction. Okay, therefore, secondary coil may what? How much EMF is induced? 15,000 volt. Therefore, it is a transformer. This coil will be primary and this is secondary. That is called. Okay, next chapter we will be seeing this. E is equal to 15,000 volt. Therefore, what is the mutual inductance between the two coils? You are asked for M. Okay, therefore, you tell me what is E? E is equal to minus M into di by dt. Okay, induced EMF. Therefore, M that is equal to which implies, M that is equal to, okay, minus E divided by di by dt. Okay, therefore that will be equal to, what is that, 15,000 minus 15,000, it is equal to minus 15,000, okay, into di by dt means divided by minus 3000. है ना, राइट? Therefore, what is your E? Are you following? Minus E divided by B by D by dt is minus 3000 na ampere per second na. Therefore, E will be 5 Henry. How it will be Henry? 5 volt. See, sorry, you are asked by M only na. You are asked by M, correct? It is not E. It is correct. First is this M. Therefore, M that is equal to 5 Henry. M that is equal to 5 Henry. Mutually, what is a mutual inductance? Mutual inductance for the given pair of coil, that is between primary and secondary, is 5 Henry. That's